Okay, let's go on. I think there's another question, ma'am, behind. Yep, right here. No, you're not there. Not you're just looking back. Yeah, that's right, you.
Well, I wanted to know if either one of you wanted to know what a definition of naturalism is.
Sure, go ahead.
It is the philosophical belief that everything arises from natural properties and causes, and supernatural or spiritual explanations are excluded or discounted. Is that what you meant, Bernie?
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's what I thought I said.
Everyone else seems to be making a comment, so I'm going to make a comment.
Did you have another question you want to ask?
Well, what, I mean, what would Pastor Nathan say to that? Because Pastor Nathan said there was a different definition.
Well, I think if you do some more research, you'll see that naturalism is a particular philosophy that believes more than what you just read, and it believes in an impersonal fate, and that leads to despair, because there is no way that you or I, or us collectively, can do anything about these natural processes going forward.
Okay, I have a question.
Yeah.
If we're talking about something like energy or electromagnetism, there are processes to discern whether that exists that one can repeat over time. What processes do you believe exist to prove that there's a soul? Or that angels exist that can be repeated and shown, or demons, or anything that's...
Yeah. Well, I would say generally, Karen, that in this world, you and I believe in hundreds upon hundreds of truths that we hold dear that cannot be substantiated in a Petri dish or in some other kind of a lab experiment. And you just have to think about everything that you hold dear and that you believe. Begin with relationships. Begin with anything that you don't think can grow in a Petri dish or that can be given a litmus test. Not everything that we hold to be real and true is material or defined by some kind of a material test performed in a laboratory. Just think about everything you believe in.
Well, I would have a comment there. You said there's hundreds of things we believe in that don't have evidence that they exist. I mean, I can't think of one thing, really.
Well, go to the laboratory and find a laboratory test that will prove to you that your wife loves you.
Okay, so I don't need to go into the laboratory to find out if something's true or real. I mean, I can...
Karen just asked that.
There are ways to find out if you can test relationships. Mm-hmm. I mean, people say all the time, you don't love me. You don't. And what are they looking for? They're looking for signs. There are signs.
They're looking for the roses on Valentine's.
Yeah, my point was in response to Karen saying, if you can't prove it in a laboratory, tell me how you know it's true.
I didn't say laboratory.
Well, you said electromagnetic energy can be proven through tests. I'm saying that take relationships, take the value of your stocks, take all sorts of things you hold dear, and tell me how you know those to be true and real. They won't be the same way that we prove electromagnetic energy. Not everything comes from the laboratory. I'll stick by that point.
Well, they're not all tested the same way, but you said stocks. You mean like stocks you trade? Stock market?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Like, I know what they're worth at a given point in the day, but what I don't always know is how I'm tied to one. Like, am I going to sell my Tesla stock or not? Oh, I just love those cars. They have such value to me as an idea. See, there's so much more to our reality than what the stock is worth at 11 a.m. on Monday morning.
But I think she's talking about existence. We know we all agree that stocks exist.
Does your wife's love exist for you?
There's ways to measure that and look for that.
Right, and I'm saying that they are not scientific, material scientific proofs. That's my only point.
Okay.
Well, Karen, let's let somebody else have a crack.
You can't take a blood sample from your wife's body, take it to the lab, and the doctor comes back and says, well, she doesn't love you.
Right, and that would be an inappropriate test, but I think there are appropriate tests that you can use logic and reason to see if things exist. I disagree that there's hundreds of things we all believe and that have no evidence whatsoever for. I disagree with your statement about that.
Okay, this gentleman here in the aisle.